Hi there, everybody. So I'm here with Antonio. He's got the mic, so hopefully you can hear me also. We are in Vilcabamba, Ecuador, at the Matt and Angela Stokes-Monarch retreat. It's been wonderful. Antonio has been in charge of the delicious raw food. And what I want to talk to you about right now is healthy children. And a lot of families end up with challenges with their children's health. All different issues like asthma, arthritis, autism. And I want Antonio to tell us how he worked through his health challenge with his daughter using food as medicine.
Yeah, so a few years ago, when my daughter is now is 9 years old, she's going to be 9 in March, when she was about 3.5 years old, so that's about 6 years ago, she was struggling with asthma, and it was so bad she needed to be pumped, you know, the mouth pump, and she was struggling so bad, and we went to several doctors to find out the best solutions, and what they, you know, the only solution they had for her was the pump and some medication. And one day I decided to look at the medication closer, and I noticed on the pamphlet that actually one of the side effects for the medication is more asthma. And that just really, you know, threw me off. So I said, you know what, let me look online. And I wasn't a researcher like I am now. And then, so it took me a while to come across some of the alternative information out there. And I found an article by Mike Adams from Natural News that suggested that kids and adults with asthma should try removing dairy from their food. And so we did that. And within days, we noticed a great improvement. And within about a week or so, she was completely off her pump. And we went back to the doctors to have her checked, and they were blown away. And she hasn't had any asthma symptoms since. And we've continued to be off dairy. Now she might have it here once in a while here and there, overall, we've substituted it successfully with almond milk and seed milk, and it's worked wonders. So we're very grateful to come across that information, and we're happy to share with those of you out there who are also faced with a challenge like that. We encourage you to take matters into your own hands, and I could tell you that the kind of confidence that my wife and I have gathered from that has helped us, has transferred towards our lifestyle, and we've been able to find natural solutions for all kinds of illnesses, and we're happy to give you guys our support and take control over your children's health.
So it was that easy? You just made some dietary changes, mm-hmm. and that had an immediate effect on your daughter's health?
Overnight. I mean, it was just we did take some drastic measures. Yeah, I mean, our refrigerator was filled with yogurt, sour cream, cheeses of all kinds, milk, of course, you know, all kinds of milks. And we overnight went to our cabinets and to our fridge and just took everything out. And from then on, we also took away our microwave and, you know, other things like that, you know, to ensure that our daughter doesn't come across any other side effects of the kind of food that we were consuming, which was a lot of processed food. So now, besides the asthma, she actually has stomach aches, she had earaches, and I actually thought it was hereditary because I grew up with earaches, you know, and knowing what I know now, I suffered through my childhood up until my teenage years. And matter of fact, I have a phobia now of entering the water because of my earaches were so bad. I had holes open up. But I know now in my heart.
That is side effects of diet.
Yes, totally. Because here I am, I'm 38 years old. Most of my life I avoided water. My ears heal themselves because I've been able to dive in and without using the earplugs, which are really annoying. So, yeah, I mean.
And those are, you know, challenges that families face with their children, mm-hmm. and just think are normal.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That they're a normal part of childhood.
Yes.
But, you know, it's side effects of our diet.
Yes, and our lifestyle.
Really are.
Totally. And besides my daughter, I would like to, you know, throw this story in. I was a social worker for 15 years. The last year of my job before I quit and I came here, I implemented some of my family's dietary changes, especially with kids with ADD. And the two things that I recommended to my families, based on articles I found on National News and Mike Adams, and he has a wonderful food pyramid that I could recommend to folks. It's called honestfoodguide.org.
Honestfoodguide.org.
O-R-G. And it's a wonderful a pyramid. It actually breaks down as to not only does it tell you what you should avoid, but it tells you why, and it has a little diagram that is very well done. And on there, that's where I saw that kids that suffer from ADD and ADHD, the research has shown that artificial colors and hydrogenated oils are the two biggest culprits of that. And two of my children that I was working with very intensely for a number of years, their parents took the measures to eliminate those two things from their diets, and the improvements were amazing. They were off their medications within several months. So that after being years.
That really gives hope to all the families out there who are facing these sort of challenges.
Yeah.
And I guess when you break it down to what we're really advocating is a whole foods lifestyle. Just back to nature, eat your fruit and vegetables. Keep it simple, don't eat processed foods, don't have anything with hydrogenated oils or colors, added food colorings. Just, you know, go to your local farmer's market or your local market and buy fresh fruit and vegetables. And forget the dairy, make your own seed milk, as Antonio said, or nut milk. It's very easy to make in your kitchen. And there you go. Now, so honestfoodguide.org.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And also check out Karen Ranzi, R-A-N-Z-I. I'll say it over here to the mic. R-A-N-Z-I, I believe is how she spells it. Karen Ranzi, she has a website. She also wrote a book called Healthy Children.
Mm.
So thanks, everybody. I'm 5 months pregnant, so this is, you know, and I have lots of friends with kids. So this is always an issue that I'm looking at in my life, is healthy children. And I'm glad that we got to share this testimonial with you from Antonio. Thank you, Antonio.
My pleasure.
Everything is one. Everything is one. And oneness is everything. Everything is everything. Is everything is everything.